Hello, that is the southern portal of the HS2 TBM that is digging under Long Itchington Woods. And to explain how we got here, and we're about to go inside, let's roll back a couple of hours.
This morning I've come up by train to Leamington Spa, and a short drive away is the visitor centre to Long Itchington Woods, where HS2 is digging a tunnel underneath the woods. A number of us have been invited along to see the progress so far and go right up inside the TBM. That's the tunnel boring machine, to see inside and see how it operates. The TBM, by the way, is named Dorothy. That's after Dorothy Hodgkin, who was the first British woman to win the Nobel Prize for Chemistry. Long Itchington Wood is in Warwickshire, with the HS2 line running to the north of the Chiltern main line. So with the weather drizzling slightly, but hopefully clearing up later, off we went.
All right. Helmet, gloves, glasses, orange PPEs are on. Gareth is ahead of me filming. I'll probably be in his video, I'll probably be in mine. We're heading for the tunnel portal at Long Itchington, which goes under the woods.
So yes, I'm about to do a cut gag where I make reference to the Thunder Machine again, which I did a long cut gag in the last one.
Double video camera action,
where the two of us are filming simultaneously. And will this make it into the edit?
It'll make
into
it
into my edit of Jess.
I just want to know, why did I get a blue helmet and you got a pink one? What's a slurry pipeline?
Oh, so the material getting dug out, gets a good chunk of it is getting sent through these pipes as slurry, having been mixed with kind of fluid to make it more easily transportable, and then it goes out to a slurry treatment plant, which is back over there in a building that we kind of saw earlier. In fact, we saw it at Chiltern Tunnel as well. You could see the slurry treatment plant too. Yeah, everyone. I didn't look at you, I looked at Jeff, but his videos are more edited than mine, you don't really care.
Okay. So we've come on to the site. There's a whole bunch of us, but they're only taking us in two groups of two at a time. So Gareth Dennis, who is also here, he's gone ahead in the advance party. I'm the second party. But I just realised I can pick on the comms guy to explain what we're doing.
We're in Warwickshire.
We are.
Yes.
To see
the Long Itchington Wood Tunnel. So this is the first of the two bore tunnel that we've got here. We're using one tunnel boring machine, which then once it's bored the mile length of tunnel underneath this ancient woodland that you can see above. And then once we've gone out at the other end towards the village of Long Itchington, we're not far from Leamington Spa here, Royal Leamington Spa, and then we will partially dismantle the front end of the machine, bring that round the front, the cutter head, but the rest of the tunnel boring machine will be pushed back to where we are now on the slab, and then we will start the second bore. So it'll be one machine doing two bores.
And you're taking us in to go right inside?
We're going to go inside. We're going to see the TBM. Okay. We're going to see everything.
Nice save on the Leamington, Royal Leamington Spa, by the way. Well done.
It's got to be. It's got to be.
There'll be comments.
Okay, yeah. Thanks. Royal Leamington Spa.
All right. Do you just want to do my whole video?
No, it's fine. It's fine.
All the talking. We're heading in. There's a chap here called Axel. We're going to chat to him in a minute. He's pretty much the tunnel manager. Knows everything that's going on. The boring started on this TBM just back in December. 2 months ago. It's only gone around 200 metres inside, and basically we're going to climb inside the TBM. All right, just capturing the moment I go inside the south portal of the Itchington Wood Tunnel. There's a little echo. Okay, this is cool.
So there we have the slurry pipes, one for the slurry to go in and the other back. Ventilation that on top. We put fresh air all the time on the end of the tunnel, and that air that is pushing fresh inside take all the dust out. Water for the cooling system of the TBM, the water of the TBM, and compressor. That's the pipes. Of course, electricity on top, and then you can see communication. We have Wi-Fi and all the communications on the TBM. As you can see, the machine is moving. When we get to a certain position, we cannot stand it no more. Yeah. We stop the operations, we close the valve there, and we retract the cylinders, and we install those pipes on there.
Yeah.
So every 12 meters, one ring is 2 meters, every 6 rings, we stop, close the valves, get these cranes, put the pipe there, retract the cylinders, connect them, and we start again.
Yeah.
In this area where we build the ring, this is the last bin has been built, number 70, and you see the push ramp there. So from now the machine will start pushing there, and we advance again.
Someone's been playing Noughts and Crosses as well.
There's a winning move.
They're just letting us climb up these very steep steps for what I gather is going to be the most impressive view. So I'm liking this. That's looking back down along, and then you go for the 180 to get the shot of the head right at the front. This is Sam. Sam, what were you saying? It was like a submarine.
Hello. It feels like a submarine, but not quite, because everything's white and not like battleship grey, right?
I think because it's only been running a couple of months, it's still kind of...
Still pristine.
It's got some of its pristineness. I feel as the weeks and months tick by, it'll become less white and more...
Mud-coloured.
More mud-coloured.
Yeah.
That's... I don't know what that is. In here are like living quarters. You can see, you can sort of like have your break and spend time in here. And the people that spend time and have breaks in here are the guys that are in here in the TBM pilot cabin, and the people that actually drive the TBM. Let's go chat to them.
Always see the parameters according to the geology condition. We have to control the machines. We control the cutterhead RPM. We can see the thrust. And according to that, we have to reacting, and also same time we have to controlling the slurry circuit to just control the face pressure. This is our working chamber pressure. There is a two type of chamber pressure. Is the working chamber pressure and the excavation chamber pressure. So when we start the bypass, we have to just think about the face pressure. We are not going to blown out the slurry from the surface. We have to just maintain with this. According to the parameter, according to the conditions, we just push the machine, advance the machine according to that.
How many hours a day do you spend down here?
12 hours.
12-hour shift?
It's a 7 to 7.
What's that Jodie Foster film? Is it called Panic Room? Well, they have one here. It's the TBM refuge chamber. They're letting me inside. Whoa! Oh, hang on. Ben wants to know. He's heard there's, what, like emergency rations in here. So if you came in here in an emergency, that's the toilet. And where's the snacks? Where's the food? Oh, I see, under the seats. Under the seats, you've got the snacks.
That's a place nobody wants to be.
Yes. And back out into the fresh air. I've got kind of like the concrete smell has kind of permeated. So it's through the PPE and onto my skin. I think I'm going to smell of concrete, and at least I hope it's concrete and not slurry.
I hope it's concrete.
I'm going for concrete smell.
And hydraulic fluid.
Maybe a little bit of hydraulic fluid mixed in.
Nice little cocktail.
And let's just pretend there's no slurry in there. Okay. All right. That is Long Itchington Wood Tunnel. Thanks to HS2 for having us. Gareth, I feel like it's time you should plug your channel and your round atoms and stuff. Do that.
Find me on Twitter, firstly, Gareth Dennis. And secondly, go on to Rail Natter on YouTube. Just search for Rail Natter, it will appear.
And you'll have a video of this.
There will be a video of this. Well. It'll probably be coming out long after your one will. But there'll be top-up stuff and bonus features and so on.
Well, that. Follow Gareth. And loads more HS2 stuff, right?
Quite a lot more HS2 stuff to be found on there, yeah.
That's it. Thanks, Gareth. Thanks, everyone. Thanks. Bye.